वॉट इज वर्टिकल सर्कल? सो वर्टिकल सर्कल सिंपली वी कैन डिफाइन दीज आर द ग्रेट सर्कल थ्रू जेनिथ एंड नादिर पॉइंट. ओके, द सर्कल विच इज पासिंग थ्रू जेनिथ एंड नादिर पॉइंट इज नोन एज वर्टिकल सर्कल. ओके, सो वर्टिकल सर्कल ऑफ द सेलेस्टियल स्फीयर इज द ग्रेट सर्कल विच पासिंग थ्रू जेनिथ एंड नादिर पॉइंट एंड ऑल द वर्टिकल सर्कल कट द सेलेस्टियल हॉरिजन एट राइट एंगल. सो सेलेस्टियल हॉरिजन इज द सर्कल इन लाइन इन हॉरिजॉन्टल डायरेक्शन. ठीक है, दैट हॉरिजन सेलेस्टियल हॉरिजन इज द प्लेन विच पासिंग थ्रू एंड ऑब्जर्वर एट राइट एंगल टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ग्रेविटी वेयर द ऑब्जर्वेशन इज प्लेस ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन. सो वर्टिकल सर्कल इज कट द सेलेस्टियल हॉरिजन एट राइट एंगल. सो दिस स्ट्रेट लाइन इज दिस सर्कल इज नोन एज वर्टिकल सर्कल. ओके, दिस ब्लू लाइन शेडेड लाइन इज नोन एज वर्टिकल सर्कल. क्लियर? नेक्स्ट इज द ऑब्जर्वर मेरेडियन. सो व्हाट इज ऑब्जर्वर मेरेडियन? सो द मेरेडियन ऑफ एनी पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट इज दैट सर्कल विच पासिस थ्रू द जेनिथ जेड इन अपर डायरेक्शन एंड नादिर इन डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन जेड डैश एंड द पोल्स ऑल्सो दैट इज पी एंड पी वन ऑफ द पॉइंट एज वेल एज थ्रू द पोल्स एंड इट इज द वर्टिकल सर्कल. सो ऑब्जर्वर मेरिडियन इज क्लियर. नेक्स्ट इज द प्राइम वर्टिकल और प्राइम कंट्रोल. प्राइम वर्टिकल एंड प्राइम कंट्रोल. सो इट इज द वर्टिकल सर्कल एट 90 डिग्री टू द ऑब्जर्वर मेरिडियन ऑन द सेलेस्टियल स्फीयर एंड पास थ्रू द ईस्ट एंड वेस्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द हॉरिजन इज नोन एज प्राइम वर्टिकल. ओके, and also we can simplify this statement is prime vertical a vertical circle which is at right angle to the meridian. Okay, it is the vertical circle at right angle to the meridian. So what prime circle is clear? Prime vertical or prime control. Next is the latitude theta. So the latitude is the angle between the direction of plumb line at the place and at the celestial equator is called as latitude, and it is denoted by theta. And it also can be defined as the angle between celestial equator and zenith. Clear? Angle between celestial equator and zenith. And what is zenith? Zenith is the above the observer point, location of observer on the celestial sphere. Pie diagram here show the latitude, north pole, south pole, south latitude and north latitude. So south latitude is in downward direction from the equator and north latitude in upward direction from the equator. So longitude is vary -0 to 180 degree east or west. And latitude is -90 to 90. What is co-latitude? So co-latitude is complementary of the latitude. That means 90 degree minus theta. So co-latitude of a place is the angular distance from the zenith to the pole. And also we can say it is the complementary of latitude and it is equal to 90 minus theta. That is co-latitude as denoted by C.
Minus zero matlab kya hoga wahan pe?
Minus zero.
Upar mein ma'am, upar slide kijiye na. थोड़ा सा और ऊपर मैम. यस मैम, यहीं पे.
दैट इज लोकेशन. इक्वेटर अगर नेगेटिव साइड अगर हम लोग लेते हैं तो क्या लेंगे? माइनस जीरो. दैट इज जीरो टू 180 डिग्री ईस्ट और वेस्ट. दैट इज लैटिट्यूड इज द sorry longitude na, it is the angle between the fixed meridian, that is the prime meridian, and the meridian of the place of the observer. It is normally adopted prime meridian is the Greenwich, and it is measured on the plane of the equator and expressed in either degree or in hour in field astronomy. Hour, minute, second, that is the angle measurement. And latitude is plus in north direction from the equator and minus sign is any place of south of the equator. So in this diagram also different point is located, that is the equator, latitude. For the arc G dash M dash. For the arc G dash M dash. And that value is also for a particular arc, 0 to 180 degree. So longitude is the place, is the angle between fixed reference meridian called the prime or first meridian and the meridian of the place. That point is discussed. So it is reckoned as 5 degree east or west of the Greenwich. see this diagram, longitude, range of longitude. Here is the 0 degree equator. So from 0 degree east to west, we can measure up to 180 degree. Here is the Greenwich, that is the prime meridian, from where angle is measured in hour, minute, second. So if 60 degree of longitude is here, that is from zero to 60 degree. 60 degree in east direction. Also, if 60 degree west, so we can show at this point, 60 degree west. But in this diagram, this point is located, a spherical triangle is in 60 degree east. Next is the altitude, and it is denoted by alpha. So the altitude of celestial body, it is angular distance above the horizon measured on the vertical circle which passing through the body. So it is the angle measured of celestial or heavenly bodies, that is the sun, moon, and star. So angular distance above the horizon as measured on vertical circle passing through the body is called altitude, and it is denoted by alpha. Okay. Next is the co-altitude. So similar as the co-latitude, here co-altitude. So what is co-altitude or zenith distance? So co-altitude and zenith distance, it is angular distance, or it is complement of altitude, that is given 90 degree minus alpha, and it is angular distance between body and the zenith. Okay, so it is calculated as z equal to 90 minus alpha. Next is the azimuth. What is azimuth? What is the meaning of azimuth? Azimuth means angle. So the azimuth of a heavenly body is the angle between the observer meridian and the vertical circle passing through the heavenly body. So it is also defined as the azimuth of celestial body is the angle between observer meridian and vertical circle through the celestial body. So it is measured the horizon from 0 degree to 360 degree from north towards east. Next is the declination. So similar as the compass surveying, here some term are used, that is the azimuth, bearing, latitude, longitude, declination. So here also declination is denoted by delta, del. So the declination of a celestial body is the angular distance from the plane of the equator measured along the star's meridian, generally called as declination angle. And that is the circle passing through the heavenly body and the celestial pole. So this declination varies 0 to 90, and it is marked at positive or negative according to the body north or south of the equator. So if north of the equator, that is positive, and if north or south of the equator, that is negative. What is co-declination, or that also called polar distance? So similarly, where is the co word is used, that is the complement value. So here also co-declination is the complement of declination. So that is denoted by P, and it is calculated 90 minus tail, 90 minus declination, and also known as polar distance. So it is defined as it is the angular distance of the heavenly body from the nearer pole. So is any pole is near, either south pole or north pole. So from the angular displacement or angular distance from this nearer pole is known as polar distance. Clear? Next is the Earth cycle. Our cycle and our angle. So our cycle is the great circle passing through the north and south celestial pole. It is very simple. Passing through the northern celestial pole is the great circle, is known as our cycle circle. And the declination of our circle of a heavenly body is thus is our circle. Next is the our angle. So our angle is the angle of a heavenly body is the angle between the observer meridian and the declination circle passing through the body. And the our angle is always measured best direction. So our angle is the angle, our angle of the celestial body is the angle between observer meridian and meridian of declination circle of the celestial body. It is measured towards west from 0 degree to 360 degree or from 0 to 24 hour. So by taking 15 degree equal to 1 hour. So generally 15 degree equal to 1 hour because 0 to 24 hour it covered 0 to 360 angle. So 1 hour equal to 15 degree. Clear? Any doubt? Okay, so next is the right ascension, that is RA. So it is equatorially angular distance measured eastward from the first point of Aries to the R circle through the heavenly bodies. So what is RA? RA of a celestial body is the angle between declination circle through the first point of Aries and declination circle of the body, that is the Earth circle. And it is measured towards east and varies 0 to 360 degree. Next is the equinoctial point. What is equinoctial point? There are lots of technical terms used in the field astronomy. Equinoctial point. So equinoctial point, the point of intersection of the ecliptic with the equator are called the equinoctial point. And the declination of the sun is zero at the equinoctial point. And the vernal equinox of first point of the Aries is the point in which the sun declination changes from south to north and marks commencement of the spring. It is fixed point of celestial sphere, and the autumnal equinox or the first point of Libra, that is the for planets, equinoctial point for the planet's location. Okay? So that is no need. Bas hame janna hai ki kya hai equinoctial word term, janna hai ki kiske liye use hota hai. To generally ye planet ka jo exact position hai uske liye use kiya jata hai, equinoctial closure, equinox, that is the vernal ऑटोमन इक्विनोक्स. सो व्हाट इज ऑटोमन इक्विनोक्स? सो ऑन 23rd सितंबर द सन अगेन पासिस थ्रू द इक्विटोरियल प्लेन. ओके एंड फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज पॉइंट ऑफ फर्स्ट लिब्रा एंड द डे एंड नाइट आर इक्वल ड्यूरेशन थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड 23rd सितंबर. ओके सो ऑन 23rd सितंबर डे एंड नाइट आर इक्वल ड्यूरेशन. ओके सो दीज आर अकॉर्डिंग टू लोकेशन ऑफ and movement of sun and earth. This is the respective, this all are related to respective movement of, relative movement of sun and earth. Next is the road of the sun, that is the ellipse. So the sun has two apparent motion. That is one with respect to earth and one with respect to stars. Sun is rotate. Sun is moved with respect to earth also and with respect to a star also. So the former one result from the real motion of the earth and that too in the plane of earth orbit. So this plane passes through center of the celestial sphere and intersect the celestial sphere in a great circle is called ecliptic or road of the sun. That means the path of the sun. And the plane of ecliptic is inclined to the plane of equator at the angle of 23 degrees 27 minutes. What is vernal equinox? Vernal equinox is used in the equinoctial point. So what is vernal equinox? So vernal equinox, the earth axis is perpendicular to the line joining earth and the sun on 21st March, the sun comes in the equatorial plane and passes through equatorial plane from source to north. So this is called the first point of the Aries. And days and night are also equal duration throughout the earth. And it is known as equinox, means equal night. Equinox means equal night. And this equinox is the vernal equinox. Vernal equinox. Anyone is using this annotation? सत्यनारायण चौधरी कहाँ घूम रहे हो? सत्यनारायण चौधरी आवाज मेरी जा रही है? सत्यनारायण
यस मैम.
कहाँ हो तुम अभी? वेयर आर यू
मैम? हम अभी बाहर में हैं.
बाहर में वो तो क्या समझ में आ रहा है तुम्हें? जो भी क्लास में बताया गया इतने सारे टर्म्स कुछ समझ में आया?
मैम जो आप पढ़ा रहे हैं मैम उसका स्क्रीनशॉट करके मैम जाएंगे रूम तो पढ़ लें.
क्या क्या बोल रहे हो? किसी को समझ में आया? किसी को समझ में नहीं आया? फिर से रिपीट करो. क्या स्क्रीनशॉट?
मैम जो आप पढ़ा रहे हैं ना मैम अभी तो उसका मैम स्क्रीनशॉट मैम कर लूंगा फिर जाकर के रूम में उसका दोबारा मैम पढ़ लूंगा तो कुछ समझ में आ जाएगी.
अच्छा गुड. चलो और नेक्स्ट वीक में तुम लोग की एग्जाम भी है.
यस मैम.
ओके सो देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ टर्म्स इज यूज्ड. सो जनरली अबाउट सन इक्वेटोरियल एंड सोलस्टेरियल पोजीशंस इज नोन फॉर द सन मूवमेंट. सो व्हाट इज सन? सो अबाउट सन वी हैव टू नो सम रिलेटेड पॉइंट. सो द सन इज लोकेटेड एट अ डिस्टेंस from the earth is 149.6 km. So distance from the earth surface ds is 149.6 × 10⁶ km from the earth surface, and the diameter of the sun is about, that is the diameter of the sun is about 109 times of earth surface, 109 times of the earth surface, and the sun diameter sustains an angle 31 minutes 59 seconds at the earth of the center. This is the angle sustained by sun at the center of the earth. So this is in minute and second. Okay, it is very less. Also, sun surface temperature is very high, that is 6090 degrees centigrade and about 12 million degrees centigrade at the center of the sun. Just imagine, temperature of the sun is 6090 degrees centigrade at the outer surface. And at the center of the sun, its temperature is 12 million degrees centigrade. Also, the sun is assumed to rotate about its own axis, but is considered at rest with respect to Earth, because both are rotating with respect to each other. The sun has two apparent motion. One is with respect to Earth and other is with respect to star. So the former one results from the real motion of the Earth, and that too in the plane of the Earth orbit. And this plane passes through the center of the celestial sphere and intersects the celestial sphere in a great circle that is called ecliptic. Okay. And Earth axis of rotation is inclined at 66 degree, that is delta declination, 66 degree 33 minute, and co-declination, that is 90 minus 90. So this is some point about the sun, moment of sun. Sun is also a part of the our celestial sphere. Everyone, please mark your attendance for today's session. I'm just sharing the screen, QR code. mark your attendance for today's session. So your class is also, some classes is pending, so maybe it will schedule tomorrow. If any routine mein agar kuch free hoga, classes agar tumhare schedule mein free schedule hoga, to maybe kal ek aur class tum logo ki hogi. Theek hai, kyunki is week mein Monday bhi class nahi ho paya tha. Okay, so any doubt? कोई doubt है आज की class से related? Okay, thank you everyone.
Thank you, ma'am.